anybody that's looking for a natural way to help them fall asleep and stay asleep is really going to do well with this type of a product. And again, we really took a lot of time to understand this new component of CBD, and then we took some traditional components and combined them to get the best overall effect. So if I was going to talk with people about how to support a better sleep cycle, there's really three or four things that I would recommend. So the first one is consider using Active Sleep Booster approximately 30 minutes before bed. And then during that time, right before bed, really make a concerted effort to turn down the lights, get in the bed, relax, and create that sleep environment that can be very beneficial for you. The second thing I would say is keep a consistent bedtime. The biggest thing that you can get out of all of this is to think about the consistency of your bedtime and your wake-up time, because that's gonna have a lot to do with your circadian rhythm, knowing when to go to bed. A couple of the external things that you may wanna think about, as an example, you probably wanna stop caffeine by about 2 p.m. Remember, caffeine has a half-life of 6 to 8 hours, so it can actually make you get into lighter stages of sleep, and that's certainly not something that we want, so stopping by 2 could be good. And stopping alcohol about 3 hours before bed is also another important factor. Remember, there's a really big difference between going to sleep and passing out. That's not really what we want to have people do, but we also want people to be able to enjoy a glass of wine or two with dinner. So if you give yourself 2 to 3 hours after your last glass of wine or spirit, you'll be just fine in terms of your overall sleep.